Everybody has their own unique way to set up the workspace in Illustrator. I like to maximize the working area, so I leave the majority of the panels collapsed on the right side. But if there is one panel that I simply need to have open at all times, is the Properties panel. This panel is a lifesaver, and I'm gonna show you why. The Properties panel is an adaptable, context-based panel, meaning that the information and options shown within the panel will change and adapt based on the tool you are using or the objects you have selected. And this can hugely speed up your workflow. I'll show you the different options for the panel here on the right side, the tool or the object selected in the center, and where you would normally find these options on the menus on the left. To start, when no objects are selected in your file and the selection tool is selected, the panel will display options related to the documents and artboards, ruler and grids, guides and snapping, some commonly used settings from the Preferences menu, and on the Quick Actions section, there will be shortcuts to the Document Setup from the File menu and the Preferences from the Edit menu. For any selection, the Properties panel will always show the basic transformation and appearance settings, as well as a shortcut to the Effects menu. When a single path is selected, the Align panel is displayed, already set to align to artboard since we only have one object selected. On the Quick Actions, we have the option to use Offset Path from the Effects menu, Expand Shape from the Object menu, Arrange from both the right-click menu and the Object menu, Align to Pixel Grid, which you can access on the top right corner of Illustrator, and Recolor Artwork from the Edit menu. The Start Global Edit option will also be available if there are similar objects to be selected in your artboard. This option is only available on this panel. When we have two or more paths selected on the artboard, some options will change. The Align panel automatically switches to Align to Selection, and the Quick Actions now display shortcuts to Group and Ungroup from both the right-click menu and the Object menu, and again the Recolor Artwork from the Edit menu. When text is selected, the Properties panel will display the Character panel and the Paragraph panel, as well as the Area Type options from the control bar, if the text selected is Area Type. If the text selected is Point Type, this option will not be available. When an image is selected, the Quick Actions display the options to Embed or Unembed from the control bar, Edit in Photoshop, which will open the source file on Adobe Photoshop. Note that this option is only available in Illustrator when an unembedded image is selected. If you embed the image on the document, this option will no longer be available. The Edit in Photoshop option can also be accessed through the control bar. Since there is no other path selected, the Mask option creates a clipping mask with the same size as the image. The clipping mask can also be accessed both through the Object menu and the right-click menu. The Quick Actions also show the options to crop image and trace image, both from the control bar, and arrange from both the right-click menu and the Object menu. If you have both an image and a shape selected, the option to create a clipping mask is also available, but this time the mask will be created using the object that is sitting on the front. It is also worth mentioning that the Properties panel will often show simplified versions of other panels, but you can always access the full set of tools by clicking on the three dots on the corner of each panel. Underlined words will also open more options, like the Stroke and Opacity panels. These were the most common options for the Properties panel. However, there are more tools and selections which will display different options, but I didn't include them here so the video wouldn't get too long. That being said, create the habit to always check the Properties panel, as it is one of the most powerful ways to speed up your workflow on Illustrator. And that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching and have a great day. Bye!